Hello friends, welcome back to another video from Somos Biology. In this video, we are going to talk about the BET examination, Biotechnology Eligibility Test, or BET, which is also known as the DBT-JRF. It's an old exam, new name is given, that is BET. So BET, DBT-JRF, Biotech Eligibility Test, Biotechnology Eligibility Test, all are same things. So what is BET and what is BET exam, when the form will come out, how to fill it, what is the exam pattern, how it works, everything will be discussed in this video. So let's begin with the general idea about the Biotech Eligibility Test. The first things first is that this test is an entrance eligibility test to do PhD in government funded projects, central government funded projects. And central government funded means DBT funded, Department of Biotechnology funded project. So there are two different categories, category 1 and category 2. In category 1, there are 275 seats. In category 2, there are only 100 seats. In category 1, they will only select candidates who will do PhD as a junior research fellow, then senior research fellow, like a normal PhD scheme. That's number of seats are present, 275, including all categories. And the second one is category B or category 2, where 100 seats are there, where they will not provide you the PhD, but you can do research work under the DBT sponsored research projects in different labs. So if you qualify for the category 1, you can select your lab of interest where the DBT will give the fund for the research and you can do your PhD. And obviously you'll get stipend, and the stipend value is near about 30,000 rupees per month. So now, once we know the basics of this BET examination, now let's talk about the exam pattern. What is the exam pattern for BET exam? The exam pattern here is simple. There are these two different sections, in the section 1, section 2. So there are total 300 questions, but among there are total 200 questions, but among those 200 questions, you need to answer only 100 questions. So 50% rejection in question. But there are these two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. In paper 1, there will be 50 questions and you need to answer, compulsory to answer 50 out of 50 questions. There is no mercy there. But in the paper B, there are total 150 questions, and among 150 questions, you can answer only 50 questions. So ultimately, total 100 questions comes in, right? So there is a huge chance that you can answer 50 out of 150 questions in paper 2. So generally, paper 1 is the general aptitude as well as a general biotechnology paper. While in the paper 2 is an advanced or particular subjective paper where the questions will be more analytical. While in the paper 1, there are two portions. One is the general aptitude and reasoning questions and basic biotech reasoning questions. So this is the division of the examination. And the whole examination will be conducted for 3 hours, the total marks will be 300, because for each question will be 3 marks. Total 100 question, it's 300 marks question paper for 3 hours time. And there will be negative marking. So you need to prepare very well in order to qualify this exam. Now let's talk about the eligibility criteria. The eligibility criteria for this examination, if you are applying for a PhD position, obviously you are applying for a PhD position here. And in this case, you need to score more than 60% in your master's if you belong to general category. If you belong to any other category, 55% score during your master is sufficient to apply for this examination. If you want to know about the rest of the details, right? How and which month the DBT-JRF form comes out, when the admit comes out, when the exam is conducted, and exactly how the exam is being conducted and all these details, I'll show you my computer screen where I'll discuss about all these details as a summary. Okay, so DBT-JRF, or also known as Biotechnology Eligibility Test, or BET. So what are the important factors? The application release month is July. The exam month is August 2nd or 3rd week. The age limit relaxation up to 28 years on the last date of application for general and EWS category. And 5 years of age relaxation will be provided for SCST and other categories, that is 33 years for SCST category. And for woman category, 3 years extra age limit for woman and OBC category provided, and that is 31 years. So for general 28 years, for SCST and differentially abled 33 years, and for woman and non-creamy layer OBC category 31 years age limit. Seat 250 seats for the category 1 and 100 seats for category 2. Eligibility, minimum 60% marks for general, EWS and OBC category, and 55% marks
for SC, ST and any other category. Application fees for BET examination, general category 1200 rupees, general OBC and EWS category 1200 rupees, and SC, ST and PWD 600 rupees.
So I believe you liked this video. If this video helped you in any way, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends and colleagues so that they get to know about the BET exams, so that they should not restrict themselves only for CSI and NET. There are plenty of other exams like this one, like the one that we've discussed before, like the one that we're going to discuss in future. So subscribe to this channel so that you get to be notified whenever we upload a new video. So that's all about this. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.